He saw the junior lying there on the ground. There was no one in sight. The hot pink zebra pattern on the front screamed, "Open me. If you dare." Well, Grant dared. He sat reading into the night. As the pages turned, Grant learned more and more about the mysterious owner. Her name was Morgan. She had insight. She had real beliefs, real life goals, hopes, and dreams. Never did Grant feel such a strong connection with another person. She had a certain je ne sais quoi.
I forget what that means.
After a few weeks of obsessing and longing, Grant made a decision. He would go where this goddess usually graced the world with her presence and find her. She liked to frequent the science fiction aisle and look at the books, reading phrases and smelling the pages. I've been waiting for you all my life. But this was no Morgan. This was a fantasy, a mirage. He waited and he waited, but Morgan never came. But this did not stop our strapping young hero, no, no. Next to the coffee shop, where he knew Morgan liked to taste the bittersweet nectars of the coffee bean, Grant had a plan. He left his half-drank coffee and sat in the bushes, waiting for Morgan to return to her favorite game, drinking fellow patrons' half-drunk coffee. Grant waited and waited for the beautiful young girl. Oh! Is it she? No. His dreams thrown away into the trash can with that coffee cup. To the park, where he knew Morgan liked to frequent and sit on the swings, waiting for the one with the heart of a child. But yet again, this was not the beautiful, young, single Morgan that he searched for. Grant had one more chance. The pool. He smelled the chair, searching for her scent. Where was she? Was she here? No. Grant, he could not go on. He threw the journal in despair. The clue? What is this? An address? Morgan. As he climbed the stairs, Grant went to his love and his greatest hope. Morgan Smith. What Grant did not know, Morgan was me.
Is Morgan home?
Je suis Morgan.
No, but I...
You found my notebook. Thanks.